Yeah.
Now coming to the season, see, there are four main seasons which can be identified in India. First is the cold weather season. Then we have the hot cold weather season. Then we have the advancing monsoon, and then we have the retreating monsoon. So what is the cold weather season, which is winter? But before we go ahead, let me tell you that these are the monsoon winds. So these are the monsoon winds which reaches here. So when this monsoon wind reaches here, there is a ghat. We call it as a western ghat. So most of these places gets a lot of rain. But this region, because this is not getting a lot of rain, because these are the mountains. And mountains, because of precipitation, the rains happens here, and this place remains waterless. Some water is there. So now these winds, they reach here. And this is Saurashtra. So there is a lot of rain in Saurashtra. There is a rain here in Aravalli range, in Mount Abu also. But Mount Abu and after this we have Aravalli ranges and Mount Abu, these winds, they are parallel to the mountain ranges. So they just go like this. They just go like this. They don't rain. So they go here and they rain here in the form of the snow. But these winds, which are Bay of Bengal region, they enter from inside. They come here and they rain. So they rain like in this area. But by the time it reaches this point, means the Thar desert area and the Gujarat region, they are already devoid of, or they are not having enough water. So this is how this Thar region and this Thar desert and the upper part of the Gujarat, they are not getting that much of rain. This region, they get a lot of rain because of, we have Khasi, the Jaintia, Garo mountains. So we get a lot of rain. In fact, 400 plus centimeter rain is recorded here for an year, and specifically in the monsoon region, monsoon time. Now, when it retreats, it starts from here, comes here, it retreats. So what happens when it retreats? The air is flowing from this point to this point. So there is not having enough of water. But when this water reaches here, in the winter season I'm talking about, when they are retreating. So now they have this water, this monsoon retreating, or the Bay of Bengal retreating monsoon. It has a lot of water because of this ocean. And now it reaches here, and now in the winter season, there is a lot of rain in this region, Coromandel region, Tamil Nadu. So this is what I wanted to discuss. Now the seasons we are discussing. So the cold weather season, this starts from mid-November and stays till the February in northern India. The coldest month are December and January in the northern part of India. And the hot weather season, that is the summer. The hot weather season in India ranges from March to May. And temperature up to 48 degree, this region, 48 degrees Celsius are experienced in the northern India. If you talk about this peninsular region, temperature remain lower due to the moderating influence of this region, because of the influence of the ocean. So this monsoon is affecting a lot, everything. In this cold weather season, as I just said, if you go to the coast area, it will be moderate temperature, that is 24 degree, 25 degree. While if you go to the cold weather season in the northern plains, that is continental type of climate, you get 10 to 15 degrees Celsius. The days are warm and the nights are cold. Again, in the cold weather season, the days are warm and nights are cold. So in this place, sometimes you get the frost, that is Tushara path. And if you go to higher altitudes, you will get the snow at this time. And during this season, the northeast trade winds prevail over the country, and they blow from land to sea. That is why there is a dry season. But as I just said, that there is rainfall here in the Coromandel region, just because some amount of rainfall occur on the Tamil Nadu coast from these winds, as they are blowing from sea to the land. They are coming from sea to the land. So the question may be asked that why the Tamil Nadu region gets water or the rainfall in the winter season. So this is the reason. In the northern part of the here, this country, there is a very high feeble high pressure region develops, and the light winds move towards from this area, and because of their different relief, these winds blow through the Ganga Valley from the west and the northwest, and the weather is normally marked by clear sky, low temperature and low humidity, and feeble variable winds. And there is one more characteristic feature of this cold weather, which is seen over this northern plains, is the inflow of cyclonic disturbances from the west and the northwest. So these are the cyclonic disturbances, we talked about it. And these low pressure systems originated from the Mediterranean Sea. And these are brought along with the westerly flow jet stream. So they cause the much needed, winter rain over the plains and the snowfall in this mountain here and here. And see, the total amount of winter rainfall here is quite low and locally known here as Mahavat. And this is quite small, but it is very important for the Rabi crops here. Then the hot weather season we talked about. So because there is a temperature of rising. So this is the monsoon coming, 1 June, 5 June, this we already talked about. So let us go to the next part. And we were talking about the second season. So if you see the temperature in the March, it rises up to say 38 degree. In April, 38 degree in the Deccan Plateau. In April, temperatures in Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh, it goes up to 42 degree. In May, it may go up to 45 degree, mostly common in the northern west part of the country. But the peninsular region, because we have moderating oceans there, so the temperature remains not that higher. And the summer months, because the temperature is rising, so there is an air pressure which is falling. And towards the end of the May, there is a elongated low pressure area which develops. So Thar Desert in the northern west or northwest, and to Patna and Chota Nagpur Plateau in the east and southeast, circulation of air begins to set around this trough. There is one more striking feature we need to discuss, that is Lu. And these are very strong, gusty, hot and dry winds. And this flow in the northern part of or northern and northern west part of India. And they may continue even in the evening time. If you are directly exposed to these Lu, it can be very fatal, because it will take out all the, you can say, humidity from you, moisture from you. Then we have some dust storms also in this period. So in the evening time, there is light rain and cool breeze. And because these violent winds and torrential downpours are going on in this time of the, that is the, you know, is in this season. So in West Bengal, these storms are known as Kal Baisakhi, because this time is the time of Baisakhi. And when the summer season are closing, or you can say to the close of summer season, there are pre-monsoon showers in Kerala and Karnataka. And they help in ripening of the mangoes, and they are known as mango showers.